Okay, I'm just being stupid. Hello, everybody! Welcome to the stream! I'm Gina, aka the Gina 2. I'm exhausted. I have very little energy. Shelties is here. Shelties is not feeling well. This makes me sad. But we are here to play more Mass Effect. I was just kind of fiddling around answering some questions and leaving comments on some threads in our official Steam club. So you guys should definitely come and join our Steam group. Because it's cool and I'm tired. Okay, let's play some Mass Effect. Because I'm way too tired to to do anything else. I'm up to 172 hours in this game. Mother of God. How is that possible? I had like 144 before. We definitely did not spend like 30 hours in this game. Steam, I think you're drunk. Oh no. Hold on. Oh, okay, you can hear me. Okay, I'm sorry. I did a sound check and I was like, I don't hear me. That's not good. Okay, anyway. I'm an idiot. You should be getting visuals in just a moment. Okay. Let us resume. Hey, Curry's here. What up, Curry? Curry's wrecked the stream. It's more like you're here to make the stream amazing. Okay. So. Last time we dealt with Nisana. Nisana pulled a fast one on us, and she's a butt, and I'm very upset with her about it. Alright, so these star writings, these are all items that we can find. These three missions are all just about collecting all the minerals and stuff and items on all the different planets. We're not going into that. It takes forever and a day. So start from the top down. This is Privateers. Yeah, this is Geralt. He said his brother's team went missing. His brother's ship went missing. So we're going to the Strenis system in the Horsehead Nebula. So that's going to be our next location. Unfortunately, in this game, it takes forever to get back to your ship. Unfortunately. Another one of the reasons why I was hesitant to play the first one is because it takes forever to get places. But that's okay, because this is all about hanging out as a family. I'm exhausted. I had a crazy day. I had a huge box of filing to take care of at work today. It involved lots of things and paperwork and exhaustion. Are you calling?
Lisa Al-Jilani recently attempted to land an interview with Commander Shepard, the first human Spectre. Unfortunately, Shepard refused to answer questions, raising concerns regarding the Spectre's commitment to humanity. We'll have exclusive footage later today.
Right. You pain in my butt. God damn it, Kalisa. I'm hearing weird sounds. I think the sound in this game shot the bed. I don't know. We'll say. You were level 20 by the time you left the Citadel for the first time. I'm sorry, I'm not, you know, so good like you. What fucking level am I? I'm level 15, alright? Yeah, there's definitely some kind of soundbite repeating in the background. Hopefully that will stop. It stopped. Excellent. Ask and you shall receive, apparently.
Binary Helix has settled out of court with a Krogan group that had accused the Genetics Corporation of fraud. The Krogan group had contracted Binary Helix to perform studies with a long-range goal of curing their genetic sterilization.
Ooh.
The group later sued for a return of investment money when the study produced no viable results.
Yeah, that genophage is a tough nut to crack. Hey, Uncle Choo Choo's here. I need to make an Uncle Choo Choo command. I need to make one of those. That's got to happen at some point. This is how I interact with my brother. I haven't even seen him all day except for this morning, when he gave me the middle finger on my way out the door to work. Love you, Anne.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
By the way, Anthony, smack you up good as Curry, just so you know. I know that you know Curry. I know it's been a while since you've spoken to her, but...
Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
Over and over and over again. Alrighty. Ah, I don't want to talk to you, you racist douche. You're on the XL because you were third in command, alright? How many commands am I gonna make? As many as I want. It's my channel. I'll go bananas if I feel like it. Okay, I believe we need to go to the Horsehead Nebula. Here we go. Oh, we need to go to Strenus. Here we go. Or Strenus? Strenus? Genophage. Yo, Curry, quiet with the spoilers, okay? The genophage is very painful and it makes me sad. Woo! 835 tickets. Damn, Shelties! Openly weeps. Curry is crying. Alright, let's see if I can remember. I believe it's Zawin. Yes. No, it's not. I don't know why Zawin sounds familiar to me. Novaria, we're obviously not going. No, Novaria's in a different thing. I'm out of it. Traylin. I don't know which one of these it is. I have to just keep clicking on them until I find the one. Until I find the one that it lets me land on. I can survey. Gas deposits surveyed. Scans from orbit have detected a large concentration of helium-3. Yay. We found things. It's gotta be Yunthoral then. Oh, I can survey this. Medallion recovered. You scanned it, uncovered an ancient deep space probe slowly orbiting Yunthoral. Tali brought it on board, dismantled it, and found a League of One medallion hidden in its payload. Sweet. If it's not any of these, though, then what is it? Unless I'm missing one. Oh, I know what I think this is. I think this is, where we have to click around and look for the... Yeah! That's right. I knew Zawin sounded familiar because it's right next to Zawin. Yeah, we have to click around and look for it. Yeah, I do it. I'm gonna land on the sun, okay? Tali, stop bringing pets. Chitika does not happen until Mass Effect 3. Scan. A faint trail of radioactive particles, possibly exhaust from a sublight nuclear engine drive, leads towards the nearby planet of Zawin. Now we can go to Zawin. Thank you, I appreciate it. Couldn't just land there before. And we've got a level 1 cold hazard. We gotta be careful or we'll freeze to death. I wouldn't freeze to death if I scanned the sun first. No, I'm joking. Okay, who should I bring with me? Make my life choices for me, people. Who should I bring with me? God. I'm yawning, I don't know what the fuck is wrong with me. Oh, In other news, I just threw $80 at a Brandon Sanderson board game Kickstarter. It was just going to be 50, but then they got to the goal where they have the expansion, and I was like, oh no. Put that expansion though. The genophage will say no babies for you. That is true. Alright, nobody's replying as far as who they want to bring, so I'm just going to say Rex and Ashley. Frags is here! The family troll has arrived! Watch out, ladies and gentlemen. Dad family troll though. What is up, Frags? How are you, my friend? Okay, we've got a lot of stuff to search for here. We've got these three anomalies here. Let's go look at some of this other stuff first, though. Oh, also, let's level up what we can level up. Fitness. Well, to be honest, Anthony, I mean, Frags was here regularly before you were. You know, maybe if you were, you know, like, a nicer brother, you would have been here first. Oh, shit! Thrash him attack! We're gonna get our asses beat! I don't want to exit the Mako! What do you think, I am suicidal? Jesus Christ! Oh, I overheated my guns. Oh, I've also got an injured tire. I don't think going back onto the ship heals it. I forget what how you heal your Mako. I mean, aside from, okay, we got him. Oh, no, we didn't. Ah, God. Now we got him. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Did you guys see that? He went flying into the air! Good job, you glitchy bastard. All right. Let's go through here. Oh, my electronic skill is too low, of course. The problems of not being a tech person. Okay. Next, let's go. Actually, you know what? Let's stay in the area. Let's go to this mercenary camp. I'm sorry, this anomaly. Oh, shit. I used my Omni-Gel. Fuck. I didn't want to use the Omni-Gel. I hit some kind of a Omni-Gel hockey. Yeah, you and Uncle Choo Choo are pretty much the men in the family. Well, actually, no, because one of the red twins is a boy as well. Red Moon is a boy as well, and we also Ray, but we haven't seen Ray in quite some time, so. What's this? Ancient debris. Let's recover this priceless artifact. I'm an idiot. Insignia recovered. The fragment appears to be from an old model freighter. Part of it is marked with the Chati Outpost insignia. Cool. Okay. Let's go check out this anomaly. Oh yes, and Chip, you are correct, Fergie. You are 1000% correct. Thank you for correcting me. Chip is also, Is is also a male member of our crew. Did so? Wait, nicer? Wait. Did I say that you were nicer, Anthony? Because that is definitely not true. You're a jerk. But I love you, though.
Heading to position.
Ooh, dead body. It appears this person was trying to mark the nearby mineral deposit when he died or was killed. Maybe he froze to death. Somebody's dumb. Let's get this deposit while we're here. Let's survey this mineral. A small deposit of iridium. Oh god. All of a sudden I'm having Mass Effect 3 flashbacks. Iridium? Iridium! Oh god, no more iridium. Or even worse, Mass Effect 2 flashbacks of mining every goddamn planet. Setting down freaking probes for days. Just wait till we just start probing everything, guys. Teehee. Probes. There appears to be no one left at this camp. The generator is still functioning, but there are no signs of the former occupants.
To my side, my noble Einherjar.
The camp's computer notes several locations of interest. Proxy Volvo driver! Hey, buddy! Thanks for the follow! What up, Chin? What up, boy? Proxy Volvo driver's a good friend of mine. He's fantastic. Thanks for the follow, man. I appreciate it. Love the support. Everybody give Proxy a big warm welcome to the Choo Choo Club. He's a good friend of mine. And Uncle Choo Choo's. And there goes Uncle Choo Choo. Calling him a slut. I love it. Alrighty. So next we're gonna go here to this anomaly. No. I'm gonna go here to this anomaly. Thank you. And then we're gonna go to that camp. Because we're still trying to find, it looks like that might have been maybe from the ship that went down, you know? We don't know. Is this a new one that we need to get or no? I forget. I forget how they designate. Yeah, no, we didn't get this one. Let's get it. Let's get it. Woo! Electric bars of cobalt. Nice. Paragon or Renegade? I think we're going to be going Paragon. A Paragade, that is, you know. The general consensus in the group is very nice and loyal to our crew and unrepentant asshole to anybody else who pisses us off. That's kind of the way we're going. I'm okay with it. The beacon was a geth trap! No! You geth bastards! No! How dare you take advantage of my trusting nature, you bitch! I was hoping to dodge that one. Alright. Oh, what jerks! What jerks! Alright. Now let's go over to this place. Yes! Always assumed her ass. Hey, laptop. None of that, thank you. Ooh, what is this? I'm kind of not parked on the terrain. Yeah, sorry about that. Wow, really? Mass Effect Parking Simulator. I don't know if I can park down here at all. Okay, there we go. I was gonna say, I might have to park at the top and hoof it down. I wouldn't want to do that. Because that is annoying. Alright, we got Palladium. But where is the mercenary camp? Yes, this is our next destination. Mako driving at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Frags! Yeah, this is kind of like Crazy Taxi. Alrighty, here we go. There's obviously some Geth activity over yonder. Oh, look at these bastards. Wow, look at this. They're firing at us while we're up over here. What jerks. Get out and try to fight these guys. Get what we can, as far as experience is concerned. Gotta make sure we take care of the Mako, though. I think I told you guys, I don't know if you weren't here yesterday, this game has a weird kind of quirk where if the Mako gets really badly damaged to the point where it would be destroyed while you're not in it, and then you get in it, you'll just automatically die. It's annoying. Look, every once in a while, you just want to run over some bitches, all right?
We're taking damage.
Thank you.
Negative contacts.
Thank you for that, Ashley. Front door service, let's go in. Red Moon is here. What's up, Red Moon? How are you, my friend? Thank you so much for joining us. So good to see you again. How's your day been? Ooh. Oh no. I'm sensing shenanigans.
Enemy is everywhere!
I'm on.
Ragdoll physics, though.
Hold the line.
You must die. You must die.
Woo!
Enemy is everywhere.
I keep forgetting that there's not a reload button in this game. I get trigger happy. Yeah, I love it. Enemies everywhere. Yeah, get used to screaming everyone is everywhere. Enemies everywhere. Get used to hearing that. That and I should go. You're gonna get sick of it real quick. I'm alright. Yeah, I had a pretty rough day at work today. It was a lot of crap going on and heavy lifting, which I don't deal with often. But when I do, I do.
Is everywhere.
Oh god. Look at this dude just chilling here. Dude, I just killed all your friends. What are you thinking?
That's it. Bag them and tag them.
Frags. Yeah, I can't believe that I'm this high energy because I'm exhausted. Oh gosh, alright. Let's do a quick scan of, is there anything better I can give my characters? Oh! Give you a new sniper rifle. I get so fucking picky. Yeah, I'm fine with the toxic damage. First aid interface. I would love toxic seals, actually. Let's give you. Let's make you hard. Yeah, you're the big smasher. You can just, I just don't want to give Ashley anything nice. People that have been watching are already like not happy with Ashley. I should omni-gel some of this stuff. Because I used some, and also I really need to make sure that I keep up on my omni-gel. Because later on, I'm going to regret it if I don't. See, this stuff isn't fun to watch. This is why I was concerned about this game. That's alright. Alright, let's go and see what is going on. Yeah, a lot of people believe she's very racist. You know what it is? I think it's very much a reflection of, like, some of the stuff that's going on in the world right now. Where she looks at the aliens and she's like, look what they did to us. Aliens are terrible. And you're like, but not all the aliens are like that. And she's like, but aliens ruined my planet and my humans. And, yeah. A lot of, she gives off a lot of racist-y vibes. I don't know if you really could consider her racist. I don't know. People get... Oh, gosh. Here we go. You have discovered the corpse of Captain Willem of the MSV Majesty. His stiff fingers are wrapped tightly around a small data pad. All right, we took the data pad. I guess we'll give that to his brother. That sucks. I believe that should be the end of the privateers. Yeah, we gotta go. All right, so... That we're gonna have to talk to Garroth about. So that's the end of that mission. I'm not gonna go back to the Citadel and turn it in yet. I'm gonna try to do as many as possible and then turn them all in at the same time, because going to the Citadel and back takes so much time because of all the elevator nonsense. So we're gonna try and be efficient with our time. I come for the dudes. We have some pretty cool dudes in our group. Proxy Volvo driver is another dude. We're up in the dude quotient. I'm all about it. Alright, return to the Normandy. Alrighty. So, the next one we're gonna do, we did privateers. Next is missing marines. The Sparta system and the Artemis Tau cluster. So, Artemis Tau, Sparta. Let's go do it. We've been spending a lot of time in the Artemis Tau cluster this game so far. Artemis Tau. Sparta. Spartans! I love all the dudes.
Commander, I'm picking up a signal from the planet's surface.
Oh, I picked the right planet.
It looks like an automated distress beacon.
Oh, whoa. I picked the right planet. First time on. Aldous is, I should read some of this a little bit. A terrestrial planet with an atmosphere of carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Aldous' surface is covered by wide deserts of silicate sand with only a few areas of indigenous rock islands to break the abrasive dust-choked winds. Its orbit is congested with debris thrown inwards by the gravity of the gas giant Ontamalka. Due to a high rate of meteor impacts, the exploration is highly dangerous, so we're gonna go land on the fucking planet. Yeah, I'm gonna read a little bit about the planets as I land on them. Okay, so we took Ashley and Rex on our last little mission. Who should we take this time? Let's see if you guys have an opinion. I'll give you guys a brief moment of time to give me some preferences, suggestions, complaints, buts, whatever you want to give me. Whatever it is. We need tech. Okay. So we'll take Tali. And Garbus. And I will continue to call him Garbus, by the way. I'm sorry. I love these scenes because you can literally see like this stuff going crazy in its atmosphere that you read about. Like, they did such a good job with the planets in this game. Go with the hot alien chick. Okay, so that's the anomaly. Okay, so let's go here first and then to the anomaly and then to the distress signal. And you can hear the debris hitting the planet. Like, they just did such a good job with the atmosphere in this game. The controls and the combat are very stiff, but man, they really did hit some nails on the head with this game, I have to say. I see a mineral deposit there. I'm not gonna go crazy with the mineral deposits. We really don't need them. If we run into some on the way, that's one thing, but I'm gonna have to go up the top of this mountain. I don't feel like chasing after that mineral, so. This is why I love the Mako. I can go full Skyrim and just walk over the fucking mountains. I can't be bothered to find correct paths. There are none. The correct path is forward. Alrighty. Ooh. Almost. My timing was off. Oh, I'm gonna lose it! Ah, yeah, I fucked it up. Alright. Whatever. Win some, lose some. Not gonna freak out over it. This series is so good. And this is the first game. I mean, the second game is one of the best games I've ever played in my life. The third one is great as well, but it has its issues. But the second one is damn near perfect. It's just fantastic. The second one, they made the combat so fluid. Like, it's just, you feel like you have more control, and it's hard to describe. It's a fantastic series. The story is amazing. The characters are I could gush about it forever. My friends will tell you I have a problem with this game. Ooh, a dead Solarian. What up, buddy, buddy? Let's dig into his body. You found Captain Mylon's identification tag. How it ended up here is impossible to know for sure. I don't know, his body's here, so I think we could we could hazard a guess. Which reminds me. We should be we should be upping our characters. Beautiful. On to the distress beacon. them red twins, though. The red twins are the best twins. I love that we really are a family. We have twins. We have two grandmas now. Because Curry is definitely one of my mamas. We have our troll brother, Uncle Choo Choo. We have the family troll. Oh no! I wonder why the distress beacon was put here. Somebody tangled up with a Thresher Maw. Oh! Okay. Okay. Bye bye. That was a little too close for comfort. That literally made my Mako jump. Yep, he got me. Oh, the Mako's all fucked up now. I gotta do some repairs on the Mako. Alrighty, there we go. Alright, we're repaired. That's what sucks about him, is that when he flips you over, like, your Mako gets damaged regardless of the amount of shields you have on it. He flipped us the fuck over. Alright, we got him. Sweet. Excellent.
I'm on my way.
Alliance soldiers. Looks like they were lured here by the distress beacon.
They came to try and help, and that sucked for them. Alright, missing Marines. Alright, so we're gonna go speak on to Admiral Kohaku there. Oh, I have to look up when we speak to Conrad next. Hold on just one second. I know the first time is when you first see him. The second time is after becoming a specter. The third interaction... Oh! Okay. The third interaction is after having completed a core world. Which we did. We went and one of the core worlds was where we got Liara. So we're going to go talk to him next time we are on there as well. Unusual readings. Yeah, this is from the computer that we hacked in Udita's office. We're going to go to the Hydra system in the Argus Row cluster. You're a twin in real life? Oh my god, that's so cool. That is so cool. That is super cool. Beta Armstrong Kepler Argus Road Hydra System. Okay, so you're fraternal twins and you're a sister and a brother. Okay, that's cool. Thayar rings the bell for some reason. Nope. Oh no, Met Ghost. Met.
Message coming.
Yeah.
Patching it through.
This is a general distress call from the Sacred Angel Medical Transport. Critical system failure. Losing power. An emergency landing. Argos.
That's not good.
Communications failing. Life support and emergency transponder. Won't last.
20s old. I would like to remind you how old I am. Okay, so here we have this is a bigger one, a level 2 hazard, a heat hazard. Metgos is a large terrestrial planet with an atmosphere of carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Its hot surface is mainly composed of nickel with deposits of potassium and heavy metals. Its mineralogical treasure trove with concentrated heavy elements consistently being brought to the surface by volcanic activity. It's inhospitable and dangerous, and expeditions must be well prepared to survive any length of time. It's got high mass, heat-trapping clouds, and constant volcanic venting. It's on its way to becoming a pressure cooker world. Excellent. You do look pretty young. I've seen your picture on Twitter. Okay, so we've already taken Ashley and Rex and Garrus and Tali, so we will take Kaden and Liara this time. I'm sure that's gonna work out great. That's a combination that's not gonna get us killed. Kaden? Liara? Singularity is so good, though. Singularity is so good. Anomaly, transponder signal, debris. Alright, let's go to this anomaly first. This place is crazy. It's crazy looking. It's very similar to the planet that we found Liara on. I believe this was the star system that we found. I believe Argos Row cluster is where we found Liara, if I remember correctly. While searching through the wreckage, you found an old letter stamped with the Gothis colony insignia. Unfortunately, the text is indecipherable. Finding all the cool shit, you guys. Alrighty. Let's go to this debris. This is a very hilly world, which makes me excited because maybe we'll get some sweet air. Like this! Woo! I damaged my tire. Amazing. This vehicle can take a beating, but sometimes if you land just the right way, you will do shit like that, like ruin your tire. That's alright. Muffins. Muffins are an inside joke between my friends and I. It's not a very funny joke because it's kind of been worn out. But Uncle Chew will tell you. Muffins. Muffins and toucans. I just realized my friends and I are fucking weird. That's okay, the best people in the world are weird. Oh, 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 oh. Luckily, if we go slow enough, we should be able to avoid taking damage. Beautiful. Hey there, what you doing, girl? Electronic skill too low, of course. Alright, let's stop messing around. Let's go check out this transponder signal and see what is going on. Come on, Mako, you can do it. You're meant to do this. You're literally made for it. Every once in a while, the Mako is incredibly annoying and stubborn. Alright. Really? Alright, let's get out this way. Mako, you failed me this day. I'm very upset with you. Oh, you guys are talking about Steven Universe? I don't ever watch TV, really. Oh, I thought that was gonna hurt, but it didn't, actually. We're good, we're good! I could jump to get some sweet air. Like that. I'm an idiot. I'm a moron!
There is the wreckage. I do not see any survivors left.
Careful, Commander. I got a bad feeling about this.
Well, let's go get this first. And then we'll talk about your bad feeling, Caden. This is close enough that I'm willing to stop for it. It does give us experience, after all. We found thorium! Alright. God damn it, I hit the fucking Omni-Gel button again. You know why? Because it's the F button, and when I'm using the WASD keys, my finger slides off the D. It slides off the D. I'm just gonna shut up now.
Death! It's a trap!
Oh no! It's a trap! You need to go down first and foremost, you armature son of a bitch. Goodbye. Thank you. Please and thank you. Oh dear. I guess it really was just a trap. It's not real or anything. Alright, great. Yeah, okay. Alright, so we're done with these for now, so we're gonna go back to the Citadel. And then after that, I think after we go to the Citadel, turn these in, talk to Conrad, we will then go on to our next major plot point world. I'm trying to decide if we're going to do Novaria or Pharos first. I usually do Novaria first, so maybe we'll do Novaria first. Novaria is a super cold planet, I think, because it's super... I think it's because maybe because it's super hot out, it'll be good to have a cold planet. Yeah, my finger slides off the D, alright? I'm sorry, I know it's bad form to slide off the D. I apologize. Ooh, gold dust. Hello and welcome to the chat. I didn't even see you pop in there. Hello and welcome, my friend. Unprofessional, lewd, as my friends and I say. Everybody should give gold dust a super warm welcome. I don't know if gold dust is still here, actually. Can we skip this now? Alright, great. Fantastic. I definitely want to watch the Normandy. I was going to say slide in and out of them. Okay, you know what? I'm just not going to talk anymore. Alrighty, let's see Caden and Ashley. We'll go Team Human for a little bit.
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley
what
has the
dance
deck.
Did you just do, Caden? Jesus. Anyway, sorry. Alright, so we gotta go back to the Citadel Power.
Chairman Burns of the Parliament Subcommittee on Transhuman Studies has been kidnapped by biotic extremists.
Yes.
The biotics commandeered a freighter and were last seen in the Hades Gamma Cluster. No demands have yet been made.
So this is the second side quest that we can get from the radio, so I'm glad that we picked it up now. It's actually kind of an interesting quest, meeting these biotic terrorists? I don't know what you want to call them. They have an interesting story behind them. It's a pretty cool side quest. We'll definitely be doing that. But after the next major planet, we've done a bunch of side quests so far today, so I want to get to some of the meat of the story and the gameplay. I don't want to, you know, have too many side quests all at once. But we're going to take care of this right now. Because the experience we're going to get is going to be super helpful. We're going to go to the Citadel Tower. And we're going to talk to Kohaku and that other guy. Whatever his name was. Hey dude, your brother's dead. Sorry.
Any news? Did you find my brother yet?
We're going to be honest with him.
I found your brother's body. His ship was attacked by privateers.
Willem's dead? I guess I should have expected this. When his ship dropped out of contact, I just knew. But I kept hoping he might still be alive.
I'm sorry for your loss.
We'll be compassionate.
Thank you for finding him. It's better to know one way or the other. That's what they say, right? Please excuse me. I need to go make arrangements for his funeral.
Okay. So that quest is donezo. Our next order of business is talking to Admiral Kohaku. I keep pronouncing it wrong.
Commander, any word on my missing men?
I'm not sure how to tell you this, Admiral. Your men were killed by a Thresher Maw.
A Thresher Maw?
Yeah.
That's not... My men wouldn't just stumble into a Thresher nest. Not the entire unit.
Somebody lured them there with an Alliance distress beacon. Placed it perfectly so they'd land right beside the Thresher nest.
Damn it. I had a bad feeling about this ever since my team disappeared. An Alliance beacon used as bait. My unit wiped out. And nobody seems to know anything about it. Commander, I appreciate what you did.
Yeah.
Now I need to do my part. The families of those Marines deserve to know why they died.
Good luck!
I hope you find what you're after, Admiral.
I will, Shepard. I'll let you know when I find anything out.
Thank you. I'm not going to offer to help because we have more important things on our plate, but I appreciate it. Okay, the next thing we need to do is go to the markets to chat for the very last time with, I don't know what you want to call him, he's just a person, Conrad Werner. Conrad.
Commander, I've been waiting for you to get back.
I've got an idea and I wanted to run it by you.
Oh no.
I got a lot going on right now. But I can spare a moment.
Great! This'll just take a minute. With so many human colonies being attacked, I'm not sure that one Spectre is enough. What if you signed me on as another Spectre?
Yeah, so if you didn't kind of get where this storyline, this little mini storyline was going, yeah, this guy's got a serious case of hero worship to the point where it's now about to just get dangerous.
Conrad, I don't think that's a good idea.
But I'd make a great Spectre. I'd be right there with you, showing the Council what humanity is capable of. I want to be with you, fighting the good fight like you did on Elysium during the Skillian Blitz.
Oh, God. Do I want to be mean, or do I want to... There are no good fights.
This is what the Blitz felt like, Conrad. You like it?
What? No, please. Please don't hurt me. Why are you doing this?
Because you're not a soldier, Conrad. You can't handle this. Go home.
I thought you were a hero. Heroes don't do things like this.
Oh, stop.
I wish I'd never met you.
Wow. Maybe we shouldn't have done that, guys. Oh, well. That's okay. I don't think... Yeah, no, that's not going to affect anything. It's not going to affect anything that we're doing. I was just trying to remember and make sure if that's something that I should have redone or not, but it's not. It's not going to affect anything. Okay, so. We're going to go back to the embassies, get back onto our ship, and we're going to go to Noberia.
Welcome to the Presidium. Allow me to be your guide.
No, thank you, Avena. Yeah, he is such a fragile little dude, but... it's not going to affect anything in the future. Regardless of how we treat him, this won't be the last we see of Conrad Werner. Just saying. Yeah, she's doing... Look. I'm doing it because he needs a hard and quick lesson, alright?
In remembrance of Eden Prime, we present another Profile in Courage with serviceman Nirali Bhatia. A devoted wife and talented chef, serviceman Bhatia joined the Alliance military under the Deferred Education Plan. After finishing her service, Bhatia planned to open a restaurant. Instead, she gave her life protecting the colonists of Eden Prime. For more Profiles in Courage, or to explore opportunities in the military, please visit the Alliance military on the extranet. Keyword, courage.
So yeah, if you guys remember that little mini quest we had with the guy whose wife's dead body, they wouldn't give her to him. That was her. That was Nirali Bhatia. So it's kind of cool that you run into that. Yay, more elevator. Is this my first playthrough? Oh no, my friend.
Francis Smith has announced plans to direct Hamlet with Elcor cast members.
Elcor Hamlet!
Open dramatic theater to the Elcor with a Hamlet who uses Elcor body language and pheromones. Kit claims that he's also excited by giving a human audience the chance to judge Hamlet by his deeds and not his emotions.
Yeah, Elcor Hamlet. That's a thing. But Goldust... I've put in at least 180 hours into this game. I've played it many times over. It's one of my favorite game series of all time. I'm just usually not that mean to Conrad. But this particular shepherd just does not have time. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
Alrighty.
The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
Yeah, relieved that he doesn't have to run this shit anymore. Mama's back in town! It's time! Let's go freeze our ass off on Noveria! Mama Choo Choo says it's Noveria time. Noveria! What is this asteroid? Oh god, is this, that's the DLC, isn't it? We'll do the DLC after we do Noveria and do some more side quests, then we'll do the DLC. The DLC is, there's two pieces of DLC for the original Mass Effect. One of them was a free one, which you can only get by actually emailing EA and being like, can I please have this DLC? The other one was one that was paid. You cannot get that one anymore, so I don't have that one. Nor would I probably want to pay for it. As cool as DLC is, like I said, this game is my least favorite in the series, but...
Message for you, Commander. Just came in over a secure channel.
Oh.
Shepard, this is Admiral Kahoku. I found out who set that trap for my men. The ones killed by the Thresher
War. Oh, did you?
Damn, I hope you get this message. It was a group called Serpers.
Woo!
An Alliance Black Ops organization. Top secret, highest level security clearance. They vanished a few months ago. Dropped right off the grid. Nobody knew where they went or what they were up to. They've gone completely rogue, Shepard. They're conducting illegal genetic experiments trying to create some kind of super soldier. I don't have any proof, but I found the coordinates for one of their research worlds. I'm uploading them with this message. They're completely out of control. Somebody needs to stop them. I've done my part. Now it's up to you. This is probably the last you'll get from me.
Yep.
Cerberus is after me now. I need to disappear before they find me.
Yep. So, yeah, get used to the name Cerberus. We're going to be hearing it a lot. If you want to talk about some bastards that pull some shit. Alright, so here's Novaria. Novaria is a small frozen terrestrial world barely habitable by conventional definitions. It's privately chartered by the Novaria Development Corporation, who leases out labs to perform research too dangerous or controversial to be performed elsewhere. Given Novaria's unique situation, it's the source of many wild conspiracy theories. So yeah, crazy conspiracy theories and lots of business dealings. The difficult part about Novaria is that...
Control, this is the SSV Normandy, requesting a vector and a berth.
I'm gonna shut up.
Normandy, your arrival was not scheduled. Our defense grid is armed and tracking you. State your business.
Citadel business. We got a Council Spectre aboard.
Landing access granted, Normandy. Be advised, we will be confirming identification on arrival. If confirmation cannot be established, your vessel will be impounded.
What a fun bunch. I think I'll take my next leave here.
Yeah, so this place is not a fun, happy-go-lucky place. It's very business-minded and very bureaucratic. We can't go in guns blazing and bashing people over the head here, unfortunately. As frustrating as it is. You know, we can't bludgeon our way through this particular place. So we're gonna bring Liara, because of reasons. And we're going to bring... I don't know, who else should we bring, guys? Oh, yeah, bringing Kaden and Liara at the same time is... Yeah. Yeah, we're not bringing Kaden with us because we might do some stuff that upsets potential voice. Garrus or Rex or... Okay, so Garrus. Okay, Garrus. We'll take Garrus.
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere.
Rex.
The commanding
good
officer
job.
Is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
What are we going to give you now? Yeah, let's go that way so that we can actually get some shit done. Alright. We should be good there. Alrighty. So yeah, this is a fun place to be. Everybody's so warm and welcoming. Tyrannosaurus Rex. Shepherd.
That's far enough.
Oh, gosh, should we be a dick here?
Something wrong, officer?
You better hope there isn't. This is an unscheduled arrival. I need your credentials.
This woman, by the way, is like a walking travesty of, like, horribly racist, like, Japanese stereotypes, and I can't deal. It's an unscheduled... I need to catch your credentials. I'm with the council.
I'm a Spectre. My name is Shepard.
Load of horse crap, ma'am. We will need to confirm that. Also, I must advise you that firearms are not permitted on Novaria. Sergeant Sterling, secure their weapons.
Nope.
Citadel authority supersedes yours.
I'm gonna be an ass here because this is one of my favorite lines in the series.
Nobody takes my weapon.
Oh.
Charge and lock!
We're authorized to use lethal force. You have to the count of three to surrender your weapons.
Yep, this is the line.
Two. Three.
Captain Matsuo, stand down.
Oh, no, okay. It's a different scene. Similar, but different.
We confirmed their identity. Spectres are authorized to carry weapons here, Captain.
You may proceed, Spectre. I hope the rest of your visit will be less confrontational.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
Karasuma-san will meet you upstairs.
Yeah!
Behave yourself.
Oh, that line! Ah! Parasini-san will meet you upstairs. Please don't do that, game. It sounds like a bad fan fiction when you do that. Yes! That is the line I was waiting for, Curry. I'll surrender one bullet. Where do you want it? Ah, and here's Gianna Parasini.
I am Gianna Parasini, assistant to Administrator Analeas. We apologize for the incident in the docking bay.
I have urgent business here.
One of my duties is orientation of new arrivals. Do you have any questions?
I heard Geth were here.
Has anyone unusual passed through here recently?
Unusual? An Asari matriarch passed through a few days ago. Lady Benezia.
Yeah.
Benezia. She is here.
Yep, that's why we came here, to try and find Matriarch Benezia, and it looks like we found her.
Can I speak with her?
Benezia left for the Peak 15 research complex days ago. To the best of my knowledge, she's still there.
Okay.
That's where I need to be then.
You'll need to ask Administrator Analeas for clearance to leave this port.
Understood. Can we go in now?
Of course. If you need any help, you can ask me at the Administrator's office.
So there's a couple of small sites.
Believe it. I imagine you want to talk to me, Shepard. About my mother.
We're pretty trusting.
No, we don't. I trust you, Liara. You may not be military, but you're a part of my crew.
Thank you, Shepard. That means a great deal to me.
Okay. So, there's a couple of small side quests that we can do here on Novaria, but they're not... some of them are a little action-oriented, but...
The galaxy's most respected site for independent scientific research and development. For your own safety, and to protect the privacy of others, you are required to obey any directions given by our security personnel. If you have questions or concerns, our friendly administrative staff is always available. Thank you, and enjoy your stay.
Yeah, so there's a couple of things we can do here.
The managers warned us about you.
Yeah. Managers warned us about you. Eat me, alright? So let's talk to Analeas. We're gonna kind of stay on the straight and narrow with this storyline here. The side quests here are not really that interesting. They don't really bear any effect on future games, so I'm not gonna go crazy about it. But here's Gianna.
How can I help you?
I'd like to speak to Analeas.
One moment, please. Mr. Analeas?
Yes, what?
Commander Shepard is asking to see you, sir.
Right, fine, come in.
Gianna is very nice. Gianna's a fun character. Gianna's cool. That's all I'll say. Analeas!
You will excuse me if I don't stand up. I have no time to entertain refugees from that urban blight called Earth.
Oh, yeah, and this guy's a charmer.
I'm here as a specter, not a human. Keep that in mind.
Believe me, that is foremost in my mind. This greeting is a courtesy. I will only cooperate as required by the executive board. Businesses come here to avoid the second guessing of galactic law.
Correct.
I'm not here to investigate your tenants.
Nevertheless, I have a responsibility to keep you away from them. Spectres are not encumbered by a need for due process.
Fair enough.
I've heard an Asari matriarch is here. Benezia?
She arrived a few days ago, accompanied by a personal escort and some cargo. She's up at Peak 15.
Some cargo, huh?
I'd like to see her, immediately.
I'm afraid that you cannot. Peak 15 is a private facility in the Skadi Mountains. Regardless, there is a blizzard in the area. Shuttles are grounded and surface access has been cut off.
So we drive.
Surface access, you say?
Cut off, I said. The roads are not suitable for travel. Don't make an issue of this, Shepard.
Oh, we are!
Forget him, Commander. If he won't help us, I'm sure someone else here will.
Correct.
I have no more questions at this time.
Good. I received a dozen urgent messages while you dithered about.
Yep. This guy is the supreme douchebag.
Mr. Analeas isn't the only one with a pass to leave Henshan.
Really, Gianna? Do tell us more.
You've never worked in the corporate world, have you, Commander? You can't bludgeon through bureaucracy.
Yeah.
All right. What would you do?
Talk to Lorik Keen. You should be able to find him at the hotel bar. Can't say more. Not within earshot of Mr. Analeas.
Alrighty.
Talk to you later.
Very well.
So we're gonna go find Lorik Keen. Lorik is one of my favorite minor characters. I wish that we could see more of him, but he's pretty cool. I believe the bar is that up there. Yeah, because that's the carport. We can't go there yet because we don't have clearance to leave. Can we bring his stupid head down? We'll take care of him. Dear Garrus, talk to me forever, says Curry. Oh man, Garrus is fantastic. How am I going to resist him? How, if I'm going to go romance Caden, how am I going to resist him? Ah, there's Lorik.
Excuse me, I need a moment of your time.
I'm not going to do this. I'm not going to do that quest. Really not necessary.
Afternoon. Sit down, have a drink. What can I do for you?
Are you Lorik Keen? I heard you might be able to help me.
You are the Spectre that just arrived, are you not? What can an old Turian like me possibly help you with?
I'm trying to find a way into the garage. I have places to go.
You need a pass. How fortuitous. I'm the manager of the local Synthetic Insights office, for the moment at least. Mr. Analeas closed my office. He claims to be investigating reports of my corruption. The administrator is an interesting man. He's become quite wealthy since he took direct control of Rex.
Sheltis is just like, don't fuck the aliens! An intriguing coincidence.
I sense a connection there.
Indeed. I acquired evidence of Analeas' actions. His hired goons are ransacking my office to find
All right, so Analeas is a dick, as we knew.
I suspect your goal lies outside this port.
Curry!
Mr. Analeas would be disinclined to let you wander. If you recover the evidence from my office, I will give you my garage pass, as well as a sum of credits.
I'm interested.
You have a plan?
I do. However, there is one other... What is that charming human expression? Fly in the lotion? Violence against Mr. Analeas' thugs may be necessary. He has members of Hanshan's security team searching my offices. He's paying them under the table. Miss Matsuo is unaware of their outside employment.
They're crooked.
Paying them under the table, they're mercenaries. I can kill mercenaries.
Excellent. Here is my pass into our offices. It will activate the elevator. The evidence is on my office computer. This OSD contains an encryption key to access it. Slide it into the drive and it will auto-execute. Oh, and do try to keep bloodstains off the carpets, would you?
Lorik. Lorik is great. Alrighty. So we need to go to his office and get rid of Analeas' thugs that are digging for the dirt that he has on Analeas. He cannot lay eggs in you. There are some physical hurdles to having sex with a Turian, but you can work around them. He's a perfectly viable romantic candidate. He might go with Caden anyway, just for the extra feels. I mean, Garrus has his own set of feels, but Caden has some serious feels. Kink Shane? Did somebody say Kink Shane? Where am I going? I'm going over here. And I just looped around like an idiot. Look at that blizzard dome. No kink shaming, Shelties. We'll see. I'm probably going to wind up romancing Kaden, honestly. I love Kaden. I feel like people shit on him a lot. He doesn't get a lot of love. All right, here we go.
Freeze! Hanshan Security. This office is sealed.
Lorik Keen gave me a pass in.
Keen? Are you working for him? He's under investigation.
Yeah, you're here illegally.
Analeas is paying you to shake this place down. Does Captain Matsuo know you're here?
Hey, I'm not the one who wants Keen. Analeas has a Varen up his ass about this guy. How about this? You pretend you didn't see us, we'll pretend we didn't see you.
Bye-bye! Yeah, but of course that doesn't happen because they attack us anyway. But yeah, they're interspecies babies are not a thing except for with the Asari? But the Asari physiology is close enough, and those babies that you have are Asari. They're considered Asari culture considers them like, you know. Oh my god. Asari culture considers them, you know, half bloods, but oh wow, I've never been back here. You know, I should probably do things more often. Hey, Doge! Kill more of these jerk faces. I know y'all are up here. Freggy, you're trolling, bro! Stop that crazy trolling!
All clear.
Yeah, so basically, if you're able to talk them out of it, you have a lot less people to contend with here. Skill too low. Beautiful. That medical kit. We downloaded the evidence from Lorik's computer. Beautiful. And it auto-saves. I want